Hey viewers, welcome to another game of the Casual Pro Gamer. Today we are doing the unanimously chosen Lux. And we're going to do two games because I wanted to do this ARAM game if Lux got picked, but then I got another amazing Lux game apparently that I'm going to do. So that is in Summoner's Rift. This one is on, as you can see, the Proving Grounds. We are doing all random, all mid. And yeah. Let's just do two. Why not? Anyway, before we start, I want to point out the same thing that I pointed out in the previous, well, two games. Well, actually, yesterday and the day before, and I'm not sure in every game, but anyway, I want to ask you to please turn off your ad blockers, because for me and, well, every other YouTuber that has commercials on their channel, it is the only way to make money off of this. And yeah, for someone who has like a million views a day, it's not really a problem if 50% of their viewers has ad blockers on. For me, however, it is a problem. Yeah, so please turn it off if you can. If you don't know how to, please leave that in the comments and I will look it up. I will make a video on how to turn off the ad blockers if you want to. So. Yeah, as I said, it's the only way to make money off of this, and yeah, as you might know, that's kind of hard to do anyway. I mean, the money on it isn't very good, and yeah, unless you're really successful, you don't get a whole lot of it. And basically, if it doesn't improve the percentage, so currently it's about 50%, 53 I believe, of people who actually get ads, so that means that 47% of my views come from people with adblock, and I don't get money for those, and that means that I won't be able to continue this eventually. For now it's still okay, but in time I will need to, or will have to, stop this for the simple reason that yeah, there's no way for me to pay my bills and I will have to start doing something else. Anyway, enough about that. I hope you understand why I asked this, because yeah, the 50% is mostly my subscribers. So if you appreciate this and if you appreciate the work that other YouTubers do as well, please turn off your ad blockers and we will all be good friends. Anyhow, going into this game, we saw the first blood go down to by someone, I don't remember who got it, someone on this team. But yeah, it was Mordekaiser taking it, but it was this guy, just the Twitch, just running in with no regard for his life, so completely ran into the enemy bush here. He probably thought he was invisible or something, but wasn't. I don't know exactly how that worked, but it seemed kind of strange. Anyway, because this is all random, all mid, I'm sure you all know the rules, but I'll explain it anyway. You can't go back. You can only heal with these little packets here. So the health things, there are two on each side. One over here, one over here. For some reason, nobody getting the one in the back. And there are two over here, one there and one there. But nobody ever runs back to the ones in the back. Even though they are very useful to get, because they give you quite a big boost of health and mana, and you can see that here, as you can see, at like 150 to 200, and that is really useful to have. Obviously, the team with the healer is probably going to win in normal circumstances. That's why, yeah, Soraka with her mana regen here is going to be super powerful. Well, this makes this team super powerful, I should say, but it's not necessarily like the only thing that matters. Of course, burst damage and such is also very useful, but for example, Veigar, yeah, he can't really farm up his Q, so he has some problems with that. The shield from Lux is of course very useful, and yeah, you have some champions that are really powerful here, some champions that are really not so powerful here, and I think because we are playing Lux here, I think we have a pretty decent skill set. Of course, she has a lot of AoE damage, so the AoE damage will be able to hit multiple people at the same time, and that is awesome. She's also long range, so that helps her well, stay back, and getting that that little packet there, the health packet. And yeah, staying healthy that way. Of course, you need to, well, extend some time, because if you don't extend, then yeah, you're not going to get any minions, any kills, anything. And wow, triple kill for the blue team. Nicely done. Yeah, so they do get quite a lot of damage done there without taking too much themselves. Only Irelia taking significant damage, and yeah, there are no health things up. You can see them on the minimap, by the way. Yeah, it's just at the moment there's only one up, and yeah, there it is. It's the little cross. So now there are two up. So anyhow, from just the team composition, I would say that the blue team should win, because they have a healer which has the Philosopher's Stone. The Philosopher's Stone with its regen should keep you alive. The Philosopher's Stone is probably one of the best items on this map to start with. Of course, not the only one to start with. Starting off with a Chalice of Harmony for someone like Vygar is of course awesome, because then he can actually spam his skills, still stay very well in the mana department at least. And yeah, we're just going to, oh man, yeah, he did get killed. We're going to apply some pressure here and actually get three kills out of that. So that is excellent. Of course, yeah, if you play all random all mid, it is completely random who's going to win, even after the champion select. So even though this Soraka is going to be very powerful in this game, it does not mean that her team can extend any more than the enemy team can, because it's all about 5v1s here. So once you jump in, and this is very useful to have as well, the ultimate from Irelia, really doing a great job of healing her. But yeah, she overextended, so she gets killed. But yeah, stuns are very useful, because that helps you get the 5v1 off. And yeah, it's really just, if someone overextends by a little bit or gets stunned like this guy, then you can jump on it with the entire team, and yeah, 5v1, nobody will survive. So yeah, that's kind of the deal here, and it's all about your play. So it's not completely random who's going to win, but it is definitely not decided by just the champion select. And the wish goes down. It doesn't really do anything though, because well, no AP yet, or no real AP yet, and that means that she's not super useful yet with that ultimate. Her heal, of course, is all about the levels, and it's level 3 currently. I don't know why she used one of the, or she, why she doesn't have the level 4 yet, because she could have had level 4, and of course the heal is the most useful ability. The Star Call should never be picked on this, on any map, to be honest, unless you're an AP carry. But in general, it is just a whole lot better to not go for that Star Call. They just go for the heal and the mana regen, because those are awesome. So as you can see, a double kill, and actually a triple kill for the blue team. Yeah, they didn't get a triple kill, but as a team they got 3 kills. So yeah, I like to regard these things as team efforts. And yeah, because of that, because it is a team effort, you're trying to kind of do the same thing with all of you. So if you jump on the same champion, one after the other, you're getting way more done than everyone doing their own thing. So even if you can't reach, it's probably best to not spend your skills on somebody else. Because like here, Cassiopeia overextended a little bit. She is slow, so she kind of was an easy target. And they all ran into that, even though some of them couldn't really reach. And that's exactly what you need to do. Oh, Mordekaiser getting killed here. But yeah, the stun going down a little bit too late. Are we going to be able to catch? Yes, nicely done. Lux picks up the kill on Irelia, finally shutting her down. She was doing very well. She was 4-4 now. So she died quite a lot as well, but she actually picked up quite some kills there in a row. I think that was three, maybe four even in a row. But yeah, all of a sudden she was doing really well, because obviously with Irelia you need to have a little bit of tankiness and your ultimate available. And once you have that, you're just super powerful. And that is exactly what, well, what's so good about her. Because she's so super powerful. Wow, and this guy just stepping into the poison freely. So taking some damage from Cassiopeia. While there's no need to get that. But hey, whatever. I guess we just had too much HP or something. And yeah, needed to grab that. Anyhow, large team fight once again going off. Irelia dies once again, but she does get a kill, so that's good. It was a 2-for-1 trade, no, 2-for-2 trade, so still equal. 17 to 11, so that is not equal, but as you can see, the gold difference is not that big. About 1.5k gold between the two teams, and there's really not a whole lot happening. So, yeah, I haven't received any all random all mids in quite a while. Of course, people realize that they need to be pretty special to be picked. And they need to, you need to have some pretty nice, well, things in there to, well, to make me pick them for my channel. And apparently this one had some pretty nice things. I haven't seen it yet, so we're going to have to wait. For now, it is a pretty good match. There's a lot of team fighting going on. There's definitely no real one-sided match going on. Both teams still have the ability to win this. It's just that, well, the blue team is pushing way more than the red team. So the blue turret is taking some more damage. The red turret is taking some more damage than the blue turret. And that is, of course, something that needs to be dealt with. Yeah, so trying to protect this this health pack, but not able to do so. Yeah, the what's his face, Kog'Maw needs to really watch out with his mana, because he is spamming that ultimate a little bit too much. And the ultimate, well, as many of you will know, as increases in mana cost with the amount of times you use it in a certain amount of time. So you really don't want to use that too often on this map. Oh, Irelia going to get a double kill. No, not yet. Well, there is a double kill. And it's a 2-for-1 so far. So, yeah, they're going to all die, of course, now. Well, the blue teamers. Come on, Lux, be a hero. Too late, too late. But she does get the kill. Okay. She did get the kill there. And that is awesome. So Lux is the only one still alive. Oh, taking so much damage from that. Going to pick up the health pack though. And should be fine now. Oh, a nice amount of damage back. But she needs to protect that turret, because otherwise, yeah, the turret goes down. And you don't want that first turret to go down. Well, the second turret is even worse, of course. But yeah, as long as you have that first turret up, you have control over at least that second health pack. And you have limited control over this health pack. Once you lose that first turret, you lose control over that completely. So nicely done, Kog'Maw. Let's steal a health pack from the Lux that has defended your turret so well. And let's just die anyway. Because, yeah, he was way too far forward. Oh, come on, get the Cassiopeia! Oh my god. Come on, Lux, shoot something in there. You know she's there. Yeah, and here's the power of that that heal. Of course, Soraka, yeah, she is really useful in that regard on this map. She can just keep spamming those heals, and that's why they removed the infuse that you do on yourself. So you cannot target yourself anymore. And because of that, well, she cannot really keep spamming that, but yeah, well, that's the way it is. And wow, once again, almost getting killed here. But yeah, Soraka should not have problems with her mana, because especially when you start off with the Philosopher's Stone, You should have enough regen to last you, well, the entire game. Because, well, your heal isn't that expensive, and it comes up every now and then. It's definitely not up all the time like it used to. You used to really need that that regen, but because they increased, or they doubled the cooldown, you no longer have any mana problems, so it doesn't really matter. Oh! No! What are you doing? Oh my god. Oh my god, why didn't he just kill her? I mean, he would have definitely killed her. Oh, a nice double kill there. Oh, very nicely done. They're going to lose this second turret now because I don't think anyone's up. Well, no, nobody was up. That one guy now came up. They're going to lose this turret pretty easily. And wow, that went very quickly from reasonable to very bad. First of all, not picking off the Soraka, that is a huge mistake. Maybe they didn't want to let her buy, but eventually she's going to buy anyway. I mean, she can just suicide into a turret if she wants to. Which is not a very common strategy, of course, but once you are alone, like they were right there, they could have actually suicided into these turrets. Instead of taking out this turret, they could have suicided. And they could have all shopped. And shopping is a really nice thing to do. Obviously it's risky, but it's definitely worth the risk, because if you can shop for your, let's see how much gold everyone has. Yeah, so these guys all have 3,000 gold, 2,600 gold. It's definitely worth suiciding for that. Obviously the red team just got aced, so they don't really have that much gold. It doesn't really matter. Plus you get to full health again. Full health, full mana. And you get new items, and although it's lame, it shouldn't work like that, it does. So it doesn't give anyone gold or experience on the red team if you suicide as a blue teamer. Yeah, and all random on mid, you shouldn't be able to suicide. And you shouldn't be able to get last hit by a minion or a tower. So the tower should take you to 1 HP, and that seems to be pretty easy fix. Anyway, yeah, we're going to push back, finally. And as you can see, getting quite a lot of damage done on this on the Ziggs. But as I say that, everyone got low. Because the Ziggs finally goes down, but everyone here is so low. The Lux is the only one at reasonable HP. And that is just... yeah, that's going to be hard to deal with. I guess they're just waiting for some AoE thing to go down on them. And then they all die simultaneously. So does anyone have a heal up? No. Well, yeah, this guy. But he's dead, so it doesn't matter. But yeah, a heal would be very nice on this, well, on this entire team. I think someone just healed. No, everyone just had some health potions or so. I don't know. Seems that they all climbed up a little bit at least. No lifesteal or spell vamp here for Mordekaiser, which is... yeah, not what he normally does. I mean, Mordekaiser is built on spell vamp because you can sustain for so long. And with the shield plus the spell vamp, that is just really useful to have. Wow, we get another kill here for the blue team. And, well, finally, he does realize how that innate ability works. His explosion. And, wow... only this guy is still alive, and he is at very, very low health. It is going to be hard to deal with that. Yeah, and that's exactly what he thought right now. So obviously you need to run around way more than this. Lux using her ultimate to get some minions. And let's see who's farmed, who's not so farmed. So currently on this team, it is Lux who is the most farmed. And on the enemy team, it is this guy, the Ziggs, who is doing the best job. But as I said, it's not about getting farmed. It's about getting that heal out of there. Because as soon as they can't heal, they can't sustain. And Soraka, even though she's not really super useful in the Summoner's Rift games, She is super powerful here, so we're going to have to do a really good job of staying together and focusing her and focusing the low health champions to actually defeat that. Do these turrets actually regen? I can't tell. Seems they don't. Anyhow, we're going to get a double kill here with Lux. So she is going up in the gold. Obviously, well, she needs to die to spend that gold. So already up to 1300 gold again. But yeah, well, the enemy team now shopped. And as you can see, 11,000, 10,000. So two guys over the Lux. And that is going to be just terrible to deal with on your own. Of course, this Mordekaiser is doing a good job of just staying in the front and just doing damage. But it would be so much more useful if he had spell vamp, because healing and sustain are so important on this map. It's really insane. That really is the only thing you need to take care of, that you have that. Oh my god, that was an awesome triple kill. Oh my god, pentakill. Oh wow, a pentakill by Ziggs. Oh my god, that was awesome. Well, he was of course the most fed champion, but that triple kill with his ultimate was just so good. Yeah, you don't see that a lot, because normally people well, either dash away or well, do something to get rid of that damage. But since this is all random, all mid, it is of course very hard to go up against that. Well, to keep away from that damage and to go up against an AoE thing that's so big, because the first time he uses it, yeah, you may flash out, but it will be up again and he will be in range of everyone, because, well, it's all random all mid. Everyone's low all the time, and yeah, it's just that some people just, yeah, can't or don't start off with the flash to begin with, or with a barrier, which of course also works, and they just get owned. Oh, Mordekaiser! Yeah, he does die to the poison. So Lux is the only one still alive. Oh no, he came back up. Yeah, so she is the only one still alive. But oh man, so much damage on him. Can they ice? He's hidden. Okay, so he was in stealth, and oh, come on, get him, get him. Nicely done, putting down the damage right there, or the slow, I should say, but it was basically a damage field, so he couldn't run through that, so he had to back out the other way. And with his current well, stealth, it's not really good to run away. I mean, his old stealth used to be very good at well, making him run, allowing him to run away, because as soon as you got stealthed for like 30-40 seconds. So it didn't really matter if someone put up a field like that, because you would just run the other way for a little bit and then run back afterwards. But now he became visible again, and oh, come on, triple kill. Oh my god, what just happened? They completely got nuked by that Aurelia. But a very nice nice job. Ace on both sides. I guess the blue team didn't actually get aced. And why would you take that? There is really no way to take that except to be an asshole. But anyhow, it doesn't matter. It doesn't matter. It will be up again by the time they need it. But yeah. And what's this? Oh. Does that look like that now? No, that can't be it. Is that the mana regen aura then? I think that's No, he doesn't have it. She has it, I think. I'm not actually sure who has it. Someone must have it. Yeah, it is from Soraka, so I didn't see it on her. Maybe I just missed the item. No, I don't know what you build from it nowadays. Yeah, it's this one. So the mana warp. It's really useful to get that mana manipulator early game. Wow, once again, that ultimate doing a whole lot of damage. So the Ziggs being really useful. As I said, AoE attacks or AoE skills are really useful on this map. That's why I said that Lux would probably be doing well. But yeah, also the single target can be very good. It's just that you need to focus one champion then. And with these AoE skills, you just toss them in and hope to get someone. And in some cases, yeah, you get everyone. So, oh, another pentakill. No, another quadra in this case. Oh, he... Yeah, he doubted too much whether he could do it. He could have killed all of them, of course, with the minefield. But he was just doubting too much whether he could actually make it. And therefore, got killed. So anyhow, we have the Veigar just running around a little, and he's going to get a kill here. No, he didn't get that, and that is kind of strange because he should have all of his skills up. I mean, he used two skills, I guess, but he still has two skills up. And wow, once again dying to poison. It's kind of nice how the synergy between Twitch and what's her face, Cassiopeia. I keep forgetting Cassiopeia. How the synergy between that works, because Cassiopeia can spam her Twin Fang on any champion that gets hit by Twitch, even though she didn't poison them first, because Cassiopeia's Twin Fang doesn't care about who poisoned it. So if you have Teemo, if you have Twitch, or well, if you have Cassiopeia, it doesn't matter. And yeah, since Teemo has two kinds of poison, and well, the poisons, the auto attacks from Twitch are all poison. Yeah, it's really a good thing to have. She just sniped someone accidentally. That was definitely just meant for the minions. Oh my god, that was so awesome. It's awesome when it happens, something random like that. That is cool. So yeah, I still don't know what the ball on top of the hidden was. But I guess it was, it's still there. So it is still there. Yeah, I really don't know. Oh wow, once again, that ultimate from Ziggs. They really need to dodge that a little bit better. And why would you go for, I don't know. I guess her build is just complete. She doesn't have anything else to build, so she just bought the Oracle's Elixir. It's just that Oracle's Elixir is not very good, obviously. And you might want to trade in one of your cheaper items for a more expensive item. So especially that, yeah, this one, the Age of the Legion. You might be better off with like a death cap eventually, or I don't know. Something that's actually really defensive, like Frozen Heart. And both of those are, of course, way more expensive. But I personally would trade in the Locket of the Iron Solari. I don't like that at all. It's like 50 damage that you prevent on each champion, which is not a big deal at all. So I don't really like that. I like some other items way better. But yeah, for the early game, it's still okay. It's just that, yeah, I wouldn't trade my gold item for, well, a crappy item. Because I like gold. I like to gain gold. If you don't like gold, then you're probably playing the wrong game. Anyhow, we are currently not fully in control of this match, but we're definitely not, well, lagging behind anymore. As you can see, the gold is pretty much equal. 2k gold between them, but since it's at 70k gold, it doesn't really matter. Oh, this Mordekaiser is going to get owned. And a double kill for Mordekaiser, though. But it's a 2 for 3 trade. And man, they must feel like they're super far behind. But they're really not far behind because, well, they picked up way more minions. And yeah, you can see that here. Yeah, 20, 30, 20. This guy has 115, which is awesome. But Lux also has 90, so that's kind of equal. And I guess I should plant them together so we can see the carries. Because they are definitely the ones that are doing the best job. And yeah, the Soraka really needs to start worrying about her amount of AP. Because with more AP, she can do way more for her team. And cooldown reduction, of course, also. If she gets some cooldown reduction and some AP going, then she's way more useful than she currently is. Because that extra little bit of armor and magic resist is not going to help anyone at this moment anymore. Because it is great to have, but it's definitely not, well, useful in the late game. And wow, we get another kill here on Lux. Lux has 17 kills now. It's nothing compared to the 25 on Ziggs, but 26 now. But yeah, well, it is definitely carry potential. And wow, just this build is also just fully maxed out. Can't really do anything else. He's running pots already. And yeah, they really need to upgrade this the item system, man. You can't really carry a team from, yeah, well, 20 kills onwards or so, because you're just maxed out. Obviously, on this map, it doesn't really matter. This map doesn't have to be balanced at all. It doesn't matter at all. And very nicely done. We do get the kill on the Lux, and Lux is going to be able to shop now. I don't know if she is actually able to shop, because I don't know if she has anything left to buy. Yeah, I guess this is pretty much whatever you can get. Magic penetration, more penetration, more penetration, and cooldown reduction. But yeah, she needs to be at 40% cooldown reduction. I don't know if she is. I should be able to see that, right? Oh, if she's up, I can see that. But we are going to lose both of our turrets. Hang on, I should be able to see it from here. 40% cooldown reduction, so that's excellent. Let's see where this Soraka's at. Oh wow, we're going to get a huge team fight here. And is the red team actually going to survive? Because that is the only thing that matters. Whether or not they survive, because if they die, if all of them die, they are screwed. They are, well, ridiculously screwed here. And there's someone behind you, dude. So no, it's not the regen aura, I guess it's something else. I don't know, I really don't know what it is, this little ball on top of him. Oh, a double ace, so they did survive. And these super minions are going to take some of the health off. But it really, yeah, it's not as bad as it could have been. I don't think they're going to win, by the way. Not at this point, but they can still win. It's definitely not super over. Yeah, they lost a little bit of health on the Nexus, but they could have lost right here. But they can still win if they get an ace and the enemy team doesn't get an ace. They get at least two towers, because the respawn timers are really long by now. And yeah, that just makes it hard to defend your turrets. Because if you get aced, then yeah, your turrets die. It's as easy as that. So yeah, they need to push the lane, because in order to get the towers on the enemy side, they are they're going to have to ace and get the lane pushed. And Yeah, there are no towers anyway, so you might as well push. Because there's nothing to fall back to. Oh, come on, guys, come on, make it work! Oh, this guy is so dead. Yeah, he hasn't really stayed in the back at all. A double kill here once again for that Ziggs. But, well, they get some pretty nice things going. Oh, this guy, is he going to snipe the Nexus? I think he is. I think they just lost it. I don't think they can actually... Oh, wow, they can take him out. And did anyone move forward? No, nobody moves forward. They all went in for that kill, even though, well, sending one guy back would be good enough. But they still have three up. They have 17, oh, I guess 13 seconds until, well, the enemy team is back up. And they need to take out this turret. Of course, the first turret was already down, and they're not going to get the inhibitor because there's already someone back in the lane. Did I really miss the countdown on Cassiopeia there? Such a pro. Anyhow, we're going to get this turret, and that should be pretty easy, actually. Come on! Oh, nobody finishes it off. Yeah, the turret does go down to the minions, and that was good enough. So, yeah. The Mordekaiser is a little bit too far forward, especially since he's the only one that can stay in the front. He shouldn't really do it like that. Oh, who's this? This is Ziggs. Ziggs needs to go down. Ziggs does not go down, which means that, yeah, we kind of traded one for two without taking out the enemy carry. I mean, that would be the only thing that would save them at this point. But I really are so tanky that even that would be hard. Oh, come on, get her, get her, get her, get her. Yes, finally she dies. That means that this guy is going to die as well. Because he can't heal up. No, get him. Come on. Oh, so close. Oh my god. Yeah, he does heal up a little bit, but that's still well within range of any spell of Lux. Yeah, that was not where they would hide. Oh, nicely done. I don't know whether that was a complete coincidence or she actually could see him, but that was very nicely done. Yep, they did catch him. They just don't know that I caught him because nobody has... oh, this guy still has an Oracles. Yeah. So anyhow, yeah, the builds are pretty much full at this point. Yeah, I think I selected someone. The builds are pretty much full. They do get the inhibitor. And at this point, it's anybody's game. As you can see, gold is equal. And are they going to win it? Oh man, this Twitch. Yeah, he keeps trying to run past everyone with his stealth. And he really shouldn't do that. Now they're going to lose. Oh man, this is crazy. The Nexus goes down. Oh wow. I did not see that coming. This should have been easy for the enemy team. They were far, far ahead. But as you can see, no. It's the red team that pulls out ahead there. So 500 gold extra. That's enough to win the game apparently. Yeah, they made a lot of mistakes, and that Mordekaiser is dying a couple of times too many. But with his enormous tankiness, they could actually still stay alive, and they had plenty of damage. Everyone had plenty of damage. So taking out that Ziggs was the major priority. He didn't die too many times, but all of those deaths were in the late game, and that's kind of when it counts. Wow, very, very nice game. See, and this is the type of game that I want to see from the Proving Grounds, because these are the games that, yeah, that are awesome to watch. Anyway, hope you enjoyed. Please turn off your ad blockers, and I will see you next time. GG.